Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over how to generate a depth of field pass in Maya Mental Ray, and then I'm going to go over how to composite it in After Effects. So let's get started. I've built a quick city using the ICQ Town script, and I've framed up a shot that I like, looking through some buildings. And so I want to be able to save a lot of rendering time by generating a Z pass, which really it significantly reduces render time as opposed to doing some depth of field inside of your camera. So how do we generate a Z pass? Well, first of all, we're rendering in Mental Ray. So let's make sure that you've flipped down to the Mental Ray tab. Also, you need to make sure you're running out a file type that can handle a ZPass. I like an RLA file, and it's a little older file type for it. It normalizes some of the Z information. You also, when you've chosen an RLA or any of the different types that can kick out a ZPass, you need to turn on that you want a ZPass. So to check this on. Okay, so now let's diagnose how much of depth that we want to calculate in our scene. Essentially, what we're going to do is we're going to assign a luminance value gradient based on depth in the scene. And so we want to know how big we have a scene in order to sort of set that value to. Now you could measure this under the create tools. There's measuring tools. Another way to do it is to go under display, heads up display, object details. And that turns on a heads up display right here where you can select different objects in the scene and you get a distance from camera parameter value. And so you want to remember that, okay, so our scene is about 20 to 30, I would say 30 probably, and you want to like give yourself some buffer room because you're going from white to black. So I usually like my blacks to end off in space beyond the scene so that anything that's in the scene has a slight white value. It's just easier. It's easier to see. So now we know we've got at least 30. So, you know, go beyond that. We'll say like 45 is our number for max. And so now let's set up our rendering. I'm going to select and right click, select all. New Maya 2014 new feature in the hot menu. And then let's create under the rendering tab here. Let's create another render layer and add all of the selected items to that render layer. And then let's add some pass contribution maps. So right click, add pass contribution map, create a pass contribution map and add selected. And then to that pass contribution map, I'm going to add a new rendering pass of camera depth remapped. And that's nice because it remaps the values to it looks like the gradient is just a very simple gradient that it kicks out for the Z pass, but there's actually a lot of odd information that it throws into the Z file. And so a camera depth remap will allow you to restructure that data in a more meaningful way. So you always need a beauty pass too. Well, you don't always need one, but I'm going to add a beauty pass. Okay, so now that we have those declared, let's go into the render settings. And in the render settings under the passes tab, you should see your beauty and depth remapped. And so you need to add the selected pass to the pass contribution map in order for them to kick out correctly, which is a strange interface component to me. It seems like you've already declared it here. So anyways, but now that you've done that, we need to modify a few of the settings in the depth remapped So double click that, go under the depth remapped parameters, opens up in the attribute editor. I'm going to set the far clipping plane to that distance that we specified, which we'll say 45. And then the maximum buffer value is how many values of gray, of black to gray, we're going to go. So 256 is a common set of values. You may have seen this in Photoshop, from white to black. So there we are. We've got that all set up. And now we can go F6 to go to our rendering menu. And then under the rendering menu, we can batch render. Okay. So now that I've batch rendered, I'm going to go into After Effects and bring those files into After Effects. Okay, so I've opened up the After Effects and I've created a composition that's, I did a 720p render out of Maya, and I've created a background solid. And so now I'm gonna just drop in. So if you hold down Control, question mark, you can drop in your files. And I'm going to put a camera blur effect. So in the effects menu, or you can get it from the effects here, but it's just faster to get it from here because you just start typing and it shows up. So we want a camera lens blur effect. And then I'm going to drop it onto our main beauty pass. And it's good to label these because when you render out render layers, it pass contribution maps, it'll name them, but anyways, we'll just call this beauty. And there we go. We can specify now, well, we actually don't need this turned on, the depth of, in terms of visibility, we just want to get the luminance values from it. And so within the camera lens blur settings, we can go under the blur map layer and specify that we want to apply the depth of field layer as our specified blur map, and then from there we can specify how much blurring we want, and then also what our focal distance is in terms of inside the blur map. The other thing to note too, that one of my good students pointed out, is that we really want to have I think it should just be a default, I think. And when you start blurring, you get edge erosion on standard blurs. And so they have a repeat edge pixel button, which turns that off, or fixes the problem. Before that, you used to have to just scale up a little bit to avoid the blur erosion on the edges. So, and then let's try out a couple of different focal values. So you can see that we're scaling in between. And now depending on what version of, I found that depending on what version of After Effects you're using, this may, this blur focal distance may go all the way up to 256, it may go to 1, and it also depends on a few things you've done. But that's pretty much it in terms of doing this. Let's set a keyframe here. And so now we can get a feeling of doing maybe sort of a quick rack focus, where we go from foreground blurred to background in focus to the opposite. And that's it. Thanks so much for watching.